this lecture we'll cover the concept of degrees of freedom, and we'll also cover the law of equipartition of energy. Now let us first cover degrees of freedom. What do we mean by that? Consider a mass, some mass, and let us place it in a slot. This may be a disk, and we make a slot here, and this mass is free to move in this slot in this direction. So what would be the degree of freedom? Is it 1 or 2? It is 1, not 2. Degree of freedom depends on the axis in which it can move. It can move only along one axis. Now suppose we have a situation where we, instead of square, we place a round object and same slot is there. It can again, this can move in this slot in this direction. What is the degree of freedom here? We have to also look at one or more aspect, because here it is free to rotate also. So it can rotate about its axis. So one axis more is added because of the rotation. It will have 2 degrees of freedom. Take example of a table on which a sphere is placed. It can move in both the directions. It can also rotate about its axis. So the degree of freedom is 2 again here. So this is what is meant by degree of freedom. Let us take a monoatomic gas. So this is molecule of the gas, and let us place it at the origin. This is X, Y, and Z. This can move in this X-axis, along Y-axis, along Z-axis. It can also rotate on all three axes, but since it's a point source, we are assuming it to be a point object, its moment of inertia is negligible, almost zero. So the rotation along the axis of this molecule is not taken into consideration. So we ignore that. That is why it has 3 degrees of freedom. Now let us take a case of a diatomic molecule. Diatomic and linear polyatomic gas, which is linear, or a diatomic molecule. So let this be the diatomic molecule. This is Y, this is X, this is Z. These are 2 molecules. And even if it is polyatomic, more than 2 molecules, it is linear. So what is the possible movement? It can move in this axis, along this axis, along this axis. It can also rotate along this axis to generate sufficient kinetic energy, because this moment of inertia we cannot ignore, because here they are separated by a distance. So this moment of inertia we are not ignoring. It can also rotate in this direction along Z-axis, and we are again not ignoring this moment of inertia. It can rotate along this axis, but since it is effectively the molecules rotating along their own axis, that moment of inertia we are ignoring. So this rotation is not taken into account. So it will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 degrees of freedom. And if we take into account this diatomic molecule or a linear polyatomic molecule at a higher temperature, at a higher temperature, the vibration will take place. And because of this vibration, we will have the vibrational energy, the kinetic energy due to their vibration, and also the potential energy. So we will have 2 more degrees of freedom at the higher temperature, so it will become 7 degrees of freedom. 5 at the lower temperature, 7 at the higher temperature when we take into account the vibration. Similarly, for the, let us take now the polyatomic non-linear molecule. Here let us take it like this, it's like something like this. This is the molecule, it is non-linear. Now how many degrees of freedom it will have? First of all, this and this will always be there. This is x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. So 3 degrees of freedom are there because of the translational motion. Now it can rotate along this axis, and moment of inertia is not ignorable, because earlier it was only like this, and moment of inertia of molecules about the axis is ignored. But here the molecule is, another molecule is also far away, so moment of inertia will cannot be ignored. So one is this, this also will give it a kinetic, will give it a rotational energy, this also. So 3 rotation are there and 3 translation, so it will have 6 degrees of freedom. And if we take the temperature also into consideration, you will have to add 2 more degrees of freedom, so it will have 8 degrees of freedom. So to sum up, for monoatomic atomic, let us say the character and degree of freedom. Monoatomic atomic is 3, diatomic or linear polyatomic or linear polyatomic, degree of freedom is 5 at low temperature and 7 at high temperature. And for non-linear polyatomic, the degrees of freedom are 6 and 8. 8 at high temperature, here this is at high temperature because of the vibration of the bonding. So these are the degrees of freedom associated with different types of molecule. Now what does the law of equipartition of energy state? This law states that the energy associated with each degree of freedom is half kT. Each degree of freedom will give this much of energy. So what will be the energy of the molecule of polyatomic gas? It will be 3 upon 2 kT. What will be the energy of diatomic linear molecule at low temperature? It will be 5 upon 2 kT. And at higher temperature, it will be 7 upon 2 kT. And in case of non-linear polyatomic, it will be 6 upon 2 kT at low temperature and 8 upon 2 kT at higher temperature. Please note, this is the energy of one molecule. If there are n molecules, the energy will be n times. N times 3 upon 2 kT in case of polyatomic molecule. And similarly you can multiply by n for each case. So this is about the degree of freedom and the law of equipartition of energy. Thank you.